fillet knife I was talking to you about on my last video. Now this fillet knife here I bought from Walmart. I'm going to use this one as a guide to go by to make the fillet knife. Just for a pattern. Because I really can't picture a pattern in my head on how I picture that, but I'd rather have something physically I can look at. Now, I've done some research on some of these fillet knives and the type of material that people have used to make these fillet knives. And what I can come up with is the best metal to use on these fillet knives is people use old saw blades. And I have one here. I have an old saw blade here that that I'm planning on using for that. And it's an old Stanley saw blade that I had here. I drew a pattern out on the blade. It's on the blade itself, and I want to go by that pattern. I'm not for sure if I want to make a full tang or a hidden tang. I haven't really decided on that yet. I'm pressing more towards full tang knife because I have some different types of handle stuff that I acquired through a good friend, and I want to use some of that. So started on it and make this knife. And cut it out first from here. It's not gonna be a whole lot of forging done to this knife because it's gonna be cut out of this blade. We will be forging to heat treat the blade and temper it. But other than that, most of it's gonna be done on the grinder and the side grinder. So with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and get started on this, and we'll get back with you when we get it all cut out. Thanks, guys. Let's get at it. Thank you. because this knife has this blade has to be extremely sharp to be a fillet knife, and I want to make sure that it has a good edge on it before I temper it, before I actually quench it. So it's got a pretty good edge on it right now, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to use my torch to quench this in, to get it hot to quench. It's, where it's so thin, I should be able to heat it up with my torch. So I'm going to turn the camera around so you can see what I'm doing. So hang with me, guys, and I'll get you focused back in. Alright, guys, I'm going to take and use the torch, heat this blade up, and I'll quench it in here, which is my quenching tank. I gotta turn my fan off right now so I can turn this thing warm. So hang on a second, guys. Alright. Here's what we're getting ready to do. Let me get my other glove. I don't want to get burned my hand. Now, clean up again. We gotta go back and clean everything up. Let's turn that fan back on first, and then we'll get it cleaned up once it cools down a little bit. Hey guys, bad news. We got catastrophic failure. Blade. I don't think I should have tempered this. Or should have got it hot. It bent on me. And it's not going to be any good now. So we're going to have to start from scratch. It happens, guys. I'm sorry. I apologize. There we go. Trash. Crash. Hey guys, I showed you a few minutes ago, we had a failure. I tried to heat treat this to make it harder. Evidently, you cannot heat treat this metal. It makes it softer. And this is what I made it out of, the saw. We'll put this in the vise and I'm gonna show. I gotta say, we're not gonna be heat treating this knife. We'll clean it up, we'll put an edge on it, put a handle on it, call it a day. So sorry I had to bring you through a failure, but we learned, didn't we? We learned the hard way. So hang on guys, we're gonna get this thing cleaned up and I'll get back with you.
Thank you. Yeah, it's still got some rough edges on it. Don't leave it on there, man. That's integrity. It's, shows that it's handmade. You see the flex that thing has? You won't have no problem filleting with this one. I'll stand on it some more and then we'll get back.
Man, I apologize for this video being so long. The first knife I failed on it, man. I made a mistake and he treated it and that didn't work. Look at this thing. Look at the flex I can get on this. Look at the flex I can get on this blade. If I can get it to work right. Watch this. See that? And it comes back to true. It's not going to bend. So we're going to leave it like it is. We're going to put a handle on it. Be done with it, man, because we already went into too long of a video already. I might have to do a lot of editing on it. But that's it, guys. I'll get back with you when I get a handle on it.